Hello, I am G. Saktivel. Here I am going to demonstrate the determination of total hardness in the water using the EDTA method. So you have heard the hardness of water in your theory classes. Here we are going to demonstrate the practical way to find out the hardness of water. We are going to use the EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. Also it is a disodium salt to enhance the solubility of EDTA in water. Here is the structure of EDTA. In this experiment, when we introduce the EBT initially, so erochrome black tea is a indicator here. Normally there will be divalent cations in the water. The EBT reacts with the divalent cations and get complex with as MEBT. When we introduce the EDTA here, the free cations present in the water will be complex with the EDTA and forming MEDTA. After all the metals, free cations are utilized, the metals bound with the EBT will be taken by the EDTA as it is stronger than MEBT, it will form MEDTA complex. Once all the metals are utilized which is bound with the EBT, the free EBTs will be formed and that will be the end point. Initially when EBT is complex with the metal ions, it will be as wine red, and finally when it is released as a free EBT, that will be as a steel blue color. And coming to the experiment, so we are going to perform this experiment using the two titrations. So one is standardization of EDTA. We are going to analyze the concentration of ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid which is given to you, and the second one is the estimation of hardness of water which is given to you. And coming to the glass vessels which are all needed for this experiment, we need a burette, we need a pipette, conical flask and a funnel. The chemicals which are needed for these experiments are the sample hot water for which we need to analyze the hardness, the EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, it is a disodium salt, standard hot water, the concentration of the cations are known, basic buffer, ammonia buffer, so the buffer we use here to avoid the protonation of disodium salt of EDTA, and an indicator EBT, erochrome black tea. The first titration, it is estimation of EDTA. For this, take the conical flask, pipette out 20 ml of standard hot water. I have already pipetted it out, and you have to add 5 ml of buffer solution, it is also added already. Now I am going to add the indicator, erochrome black tea, just add 2 drops. Now the metal EBT complex has been formed and you can see the wine red color. You should fill the burette with EDTA and titrate. Now when you are adding the EDTA, the free metal ions are getting complex with the EDTA, also the metal bound with the EBT will be taken by EDTA. At last when all the EBTs are free from metal ions, that will give you the color change. Yes, you got the color change now. It is still blue color. Okay, this is the end point. Now we have to note down the value. The value is 10.1. Substitute it here. The volume of standard hard water which you have taken using the pipette is 20 ml. The burette reading, the initial reading is 0, and the final reading which you got at the end point, the 10.1 now. The volume of EDTA is the final one minus initial one. The concordant value is the value which you got concordantly, the same value. The volume of standard hard water is 20 ml. The normality of standard hard water is 1 mg per ml which is given to you. The volume of EDTA is the concordant value what you got. The normality of EDTA can be calculated using this. V1 N1 divided by V2 will give you the normality of EDTA as mg per ml. Now coming to the second titration, which is estimation of hardness of water. The water sample is given, the hardness is unknown. You have to take 40 ml of this sample. Make sure that you are taking 40 ml of the sample hard water, because normally for the standardization of EDTA you will be taking 20 ml. Using pipette you should take 40 ml the conical flask and add 5 ml of buffer, 2 drops of EBT. Fill the burette again with the EDTA, now titrate with the EDTA. When you get the steel blue color, that will be the end point, and note down the value. The volume of sample hard water is at 40 ml you have taken. The burette reading, the initial one is 0, the final one is the end point when you got the steel blue color. Volume of EDTA is the final one minus initial one, the concordant value. The same experiment should be repeated till you get the concordant value. The volume of sample hard water is 40 ml. The volume of EDTA is the value which got as a concordant value. The normality of EDTA is the value which you calculated from the first titration, and now we can easily analyze the normality of standard hard water, which can be attained by the V2 N2 divided by V1 as mg per ml. Now you need to convert this for 1 liter. So just multiply with 1000, you will get it as ppm, parts per million. Thank you.